Dear student, today we will discuss the concept of traditional file processing systems. Why traditional file processing systems? Was developed at the beginning when the business starts using computer systems to retrieve the data, to store the data, to manipulate the data. Traditional file processing system was introduced. In traditional file processing system, that is a collection of programs that perform the services for the end user, like to store the data, production of the different type of the reports, manipulate the data, or retrieve the data. Although traditional file processing system was an old system, but it is still widely used today, especially for database backup purposes. Traditional file processing system. Each programs or departments have to manage its own data. Take the example. Here we are having the library sections. They are manage their own data. Examination sections, for that one we are having the separate applications and we are storing data separately. Each section defines and manage its own data. Same for the registration sections. We are having the registration applications and the registration data file. So what is the issue over here? We see that when each section have to manage its own data, then we are having the different disadvantage of the file processing systems. What are those disadvantage? First one, we see that data dependency. And data dependency, we see that file description is stored within each application programs. Any changes to a file descriptions, to the file structure, that require change to the file descriptions. Whenever user want to make the change in the structure of the files, then it is very necessary user have to make the change the file description for all program that access the file. There was no centralized control. So that is the main problem with the traditional file processing systems. Application programs and file description were embedded with each other. Next drawback, that was duplication of the data. Same data is stored in several places and different department of same organization. That one duplication is wasteful because it need additional storage space and also increase the effort to keep all the file up to date. Whenever same data is stored at more than one location, issue of data inconsistency is also there. Data value may not agree, may not be updated at the different locations. So we are having issue of the data duplication, that we are having one student data is available at one location, same data we have to store at any other location. At examination section we have to store the data. Similarly, at the registration section we have to store the same data. When we have to update the data at one location, if we may not be able to update the value of the same student at another location, so so data will not be in consistent form. So data inconsistency will be there. That is another issue with the traditional file processing systems. Another issue that is a limited data sharing. When we see that traditional file processing system, there was no centralized control of the data. Each application have its own file and users have very little opportunity to share the data outside their own organization. So no sharing of the data, no centralized control was there. Then another issue, lengthy development time. Whenever each application, each section, each department have to manage their own data, programmer have to design each application from the scratch in their own file format. So whenever they have to implement the file from the scratch, that take too much time to develop the new application from scratch. Program maintenance, same. Different applications have to manage their own, different section have to manage their own data, then definitely maintenance cost is also needed. Let here we are having the example. We are having the order department, account department, and payroll department. Order billing system, invoicing system, then payroll systems. Programs A, program B, and program C. Again, program A is here, program B is here. Program A and program B is here. We are having the different customers' master files, inventory master files, and back order files. Similarly, we are having the inventory pricing files, then we are having the employee master. Customer master file is available over here. Customer master file is available over here. Same data is stored at more than one location. Inventory master file is stored, and inventory master file is also stored with the invoicing system. Same data is stored at more than one location. So data duplication is there. We already discussed data duplications. We see that waste data storage. Difficult to keep all the file up to date, that when we can't update all the files, then data consistency issue is also there. Now another issue is over here, data integrity. Data integrity, that is also related to the duplication of the data, and that is the drawback all the traditional file processing system. What is the data integrity? Data integrity means correctness or accuracy of the data. Data in traditional file processing systems, data is not in correct form or in accurate forms. We may not be able to maintain the accuracy of the data in the traditional file processing system. And inconsistency, we already discussed. Let an example of the duplication of the data, library examination and registration. Registration numbers, name, father name, book issue, and fine. Names and registration numbers. Name and registration numbers are stored. Name and registration numbers are again stored. Here, father names and address. Father names is at the registration as well as father names at the library. Address is also repeated. Clause is repeated. So same information are stored at the different sections. No centralized control, lengthy development times, we already discussed. Okay. Other drawback, that is that difficult to access the data. Take the information, collect the information, retrieval of the data become very difficult. Need to write the new program to carry out each new task. Definitely. And data isolation, multiple files and formats are there. That is very hard, the new constraints are changing existing ones. that is related to the traditional file processing system. These are the drawbacks of the traditional file processing system. These drawbacks will help us to understand the concept of the database approach and what are the different advantages of the database approach. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice time.